Yo, what's the deal, good people? It's your boy, Eric Taylor, tailored to you, Astrology. I'm back with my true Black Moon Lilith house series. And this is the true Black Moon Lilith in Cuatro, the fourth house. All right, so we'll get into the Lilith, the fourth house, maybe a couple famous people, and just break it all down for you. So what is the true Black Moon Lilith? Well, goes back to the beginning, right? Lilith and Adam made equally from God, source energy, and Lilith did not want to submit, felt rejected, wanted to be on top, intimacy, got the boot, right? So then, you know, she got demonized, all this other stuff. We're not getting into that. What was really the key word is rejection. And Black Moon Lilith is our shadow side. It's like our divine feminine instincts, gut, root chakra. It is pre-verbal, pre-rational energy, pheromones, hormones, yes, no response. But it's your intuition and your body way down here, right? And it's got like a female Pluto energy. It's stronger in a female's chart than in a man's chart, but it affects everyone, right? And it's not just about sex. It's about really tapping into the divine feminine energy and kind of being considered an outsider or an outliner or rejected for being true to that in yourself in this patriarchal system, right? So what's the fourth house? We're talking about your home, your roots, your ancestors, right? It's sort of like middle school, but your convenience and comforts growing up. Right? Your mother, how you were nurtured and cared for. That's what you see in the fourth house. It's childhood home, adult home, retirement home. You can see the end of life. Past life karmas too. You also can see, you know, it's like that, the DNA, like your ancestral lineage, right? That's the roots and culture. You understand? So some of the famous people here, and like always, you hit me up. TaylorToYouCoaching@gmail.com, because we're just talking about displacement. You want to know what's squaring it, what's opposing it in the 10th house, the trine in the 8th or the 12th. All the different placements and aspects flavor this Lilith and tell a deeper story. Okay? Now, I don't know if I believe all that I, you know, saw and researched. You know, I saw Donald Trump, Joseph Stalin, Johnny Depp, different people have this placement. But what happens, right? When you have the true Black Moon Lilith in the fourth house, there can be a lot of arguments in the home. You can always feel like an outsider or rejected for having kind of your views and ideologies and thoughts that could be very different from your mother's or from the family and from the family structure. Also, in your ancestry line and lineage, you can have people who were into astrology, tarot, you know, white magic, black magic, santeria, brujería. You know, you could have spiritual healers, witches, you know, different things in your family lineage. People in general, you see sometimes there's a lot of chaos in the home, sometimes abuse, sometimes sexual abuse or divorce, or sometimes it was just, you know, you could almost even see, you could literally face extra discipline, spankings, getting hit, verbally abused, but just for stating your opinion, having different ideas. You know, it's this sonar, boop, boop, boop energy where you don't realize you're Lilith. People reflect it back to you. You can get kind of, you know, rejected or attacked for it or for just, you know, being you. And sometimes you can, you know, maybe from a sibling, a cousin, a neighbor, Sometimes there could be some sexual abuse or just inappropriate touching. Doesn't have to always be to such, you know, extremes. That can play out. Now, sometimes these people could be hesitant on wanting to procreate and have families because they're just like, I don't want what I went through, you know, the lack of nourishment or different, you know, just the rejection, just being outcasted. You don't want to feel like you could recreate that for your children. Chances are you won't, so don't have those fears. What you've got to do is learn to find your tribe. You've got to really, in your home, now that you're an adult, even if you're watching this and you're a young adult teenager and you still live at home, but you've got to find your tribe. You've got to find your, really like your place in your home, maybe even having an altar to ancestors or just a routine of deep breath work, meditation, prayer, where you can kind of like tap in and get in touch with your intuition. Right? This is like when we get those goosebumps, this is how God speaks to us. So you could be very instinctual about people coming in and out of the home, about property, real estate, about emotions. What's the fourth house? Your comfort, convenience, but it's like your nurturing, caring, and your emotional, sometimes intelligence, but your just your emotions, period. You know, think of it like midnight, right? It's up to you to really do the work, to find your people, find your tribe, but also to get in touch with your body, right? When you eat something, is it pure for you? When you communicate with people, are they, you know, receiving you well? You know, sometimes you have to, you know, love your family from afar, be like, well, I love you, but, you know, adios, see you later. Like, you know, I'm out, I'm going to another country. I can't mess with you anymore. You know, whatever it is, but you will find your spiritual home. I promise, wherever, you know, but you will find it. And a lot of times you have to kind of create that reality for yourself. Does it make sense? Like, you've got to be intuitive and trust your gut instinct, trust your intuition, get into that root chakra, you know, spend that 30 minutes a day really toning, sound bowl, but meditation, prayer, getting your knees in a prayer closet. Because you might feel like your foundations were off or not so stable. And it doesn't mean you could be a brilliant person, you know, running the world, doing, you know, working for whatever. But you just, there's something about the private intimacy of home that it created these sort of feelings of hurt and rejection and being an outsider or outcasted or not being seen or heard, right? Another thing that you gotta try to do is don't punish yourself and don't expect rejection. You can have a family, you can get married, you can, you know what I mean? Let the fears go, let the rejection go and understand that you just gotta trust your gut and your intuition. Your instincts will help you and guide you through life, and you're gonna be okay. Okay?
Okay.
So I think also you can find that you can find like the recipes and the connection to past lives or grandma or great grandma or abuela or, you know, whatever it is that can help kind of like mystically guide you through life, that you're just kind of like floating. You know what I mean? Like you can be, you know, like surfing on the moon. I'm surfing on the moon, you know, and just make it work. You actually could be really good at real estate, really good with morphing. Emotionally, like, whew, like you could have intense emotions. Now you got to look at the sign as well, right? Obviously, if this is water signs like Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, you could be super intuitive and psychic, and really should have a water feature in your home or live near water. Right? If it's an earth signs, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, you're gonna be very grounded to the physical material world and items and just have, you can be very connected to home and nature. You probably need to live somewhere where there's a garden, especially if you got Taurus here. The air signs, it's all about communication with you. You know what I mean? It's not expecting to get rejected for your words. And the fire signs, it's definitely, you're passionate. It can be intense passion in the home and arguments, but very action and energy. You might move, you know, to different homes and countries and acquire land and property, you know, things like that. So just understand, you gotta hit me up, taylor2coaching@gmail.com. Please like, share, subscribe, comment down below. Let me know how Black Moon Lilith, true Black Moon Lilith. Oh, and when you look for it, miscellaneous on astro.com, H13, break down the poetry that comes from the E, it flows naturally and so easily. That's how you find the true Black Moon Lilith. And it could be in a separate sign or separate house from, like, you know, the regular Lilith that you break down on other websites when you're looking at the Placidus chart. I'm Western Tropical Astrologer. I use the whole sign system, more ancient, more accurate, I believe. And, you know, those Liliths can be different. There's two different Liliths. So this is the true Black Moon Lilith, H13. Okay, and it fluctuates, is that, what, escalating, apogee? So, you got it. You got this. I hope I got you, and you got this, and we got that, and everybody's getting and gotten, and make it good. All right, true Black Moon Lilith. Just know, you wanna pay attention to the meals that you're cooking in the home, okay? You're probably gonna wanna cook more than eating out. Just another little thought and tidbit, you know. But yes, you can get married, you can have family, you can have children, you're not gonna curse your kids, none of that stuff. But connect to your ancestors. Connect to your DNA, connect to other cultures, other homelands. Connect to a tribe. Maybe you have a book club in your house. Like-minded people. Maybe you know, get into astrology or tarot at home and stuff like that. So, a lot of different thoughts and ideas. Follow me in the Twitter, Big3Astrology, Taylor2C, YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, Taylor2Astrology. Join my Facebook group, Taylor2Coaching, and check out the website, taylor2coaching.com. And read my blogs, my testimonials, and hit your boy up. Read the description down below, all my prices, everything's there. And thank you. God bless you. Be safe. True Black Moon Lilith in fourth house. You can be freaky at home too. You think I don't know? I ain't judging. Come on. You know. We got Lilith. Everybody got it. It just depends on what house. Yours is in the fourth house. So you know. You know. I know. Do you know? True Black Moon Lilith, fourth house, cuatro's house, cuatro's house. Thank you for watching. Taylor2Astrology. Peace.